All right, you're going to want your mat. Welcome to strength class. You're going to want dumbbells, medium and heavy. Happy Monday. Welcome. My name is Heather. I'm going to take you through your 45-minute strength workout today. You can keep your mat out if you'd like. We will eventually walk out that direction, pun intended, when we hit walkouts. So we're going to start first with some standing kind of preparatory movements. I want you to draw some just little circles, nothing major yet. Not yet. Let's gear up for some major stuff, shall we? As always, feel free to modify any of these exercises from the warm-up all the way to the cool-down and stretch. That's assuming we're going to get to the cool-down and stretch. Options, sweep, lift your heels. Yeah, slow it down, little mini squat, lift your heels. We're just going to start to literally activate our brains, our balance, our muscles. All of those things are going to be important for your workout. Why? Because when your brain is alive and awake, and boy, do I got to wake us up today, it's going to help us connect the mind and muscle together. So I want you to start to tell your body, hey, body, I'm coming for you. Hey, Nick, welcome aboard. We got some options for people when they come in here. We're going to take our arms into an A position. Watch my arms. That's all I'm doing. I'm squeezing my shoulder blades together, and I'm going to find a hinge. Yes. This is going to teach you guys a couple of things. Upper back strength. During a deadlift, you must have upper back tight. More importantly, your armpits. Keep them closed. Not because we stink. We smell like flowers. But what I want you to do is activate the lat muscles, which sit right here. So the more activation we get up here, the less back pain you're going to have to deal with on a deadlift. Stop bending the knees. We're hinging out of the hips. That's all we're doing right now. I appreciate that you guys just follow my lead. I'm like, do thing. No, we want to do the weird stuff, Heather. Cool. Squat walkout. Watch my lead. Sit down. Walk yourself out high plank or modified plank. Walk back into a squat. Stand up. You go. Find your way to the mat if you need. I am, for space purposes, going to do that very thing. Roll a little bit into the wrists and ankles here. Think about the plank from the crown of the head to your tail. If I put a marble on it, it would roll straight down you. You're going to want to hollow out the belly, so tuck in tight, rib to hip. Your core is tight. And then you should be able to start to press into the wrists and the ankles a little more without having wrist pain and low back pain. Certainly no shoulder pain. Stack up your shoulders above your elbows, above your wrists. Yeah, now see if you can pick up your pace a little bit, team. About 10 seconds. Let's just go a little bit quicker. You don't have to. Little reaction time to get down and get up off the floor. If you have kids, it's a fun game to play with them. Tell them they've got 3 seconds. Who's going to get off the floor faster? It's always me. It will always be me. Last three, two. When you're out in your plank last time, hold it out here. You can modify this. Just drop to the knees if you need. We're going to add in a little stretching of the hips. I'm going to go. You're going to follow. You're going to shift the hips back. Right foot flies forward. Flat foot, nice stretch, and take a rotation if you'd like, little elbow drop in toward the foot, foot back, hips back, blast. Do the same thing on this side. You go back and forth, right and left. Mobilizing the hips, ankles, and knees. Keep the core really tight right now. Palms are flat. Yeah, try to set the hips back. Already prepping in a squat. Oh, good for you. Who doesn't love a little squat in their plank? 5 seconds. We're going to hold a side plank position. 4, 3, 2. Meet me in a side plank. I don't care which side you start on. Listen with your ears. Option always. Leave the bent knee, bottom knee bent. Option 2. Straighten both legs, but scissor your stance. Take your outside leg, tap. And make a rainbow, tap behind, front and back. You're trying to stabilize through the shoulder that's on the floor. So press your shoulder in, light tap. Hard, isn't it? Oh, push the floor away from you. Got lateral hips engaged, obliques. Keep your chin out of your chest. Three,
oh.
Two, switch sides. Whatever you did on side one, if it's the base is bent or lift it up. And then when you're ready, outside leg, tap and tap. You're even getting a little strengthening around the knee joint. Keep pressing the floor away with the elbow that's on the ground, please. We're not trying to dump into the shoulder or the neck. We're already behind schedule. That's great. Three, two, and one. Lie down in a bridge. I told my lunch hour we got done on time. We are not getting done on time today. Lift your hips up. Start right here. Palms can be flat or flip them up. Listen with your ears, team. We're going to walk our heels right, left. Little double pulse on the butt. Walk your feet back. Little double pulse. One, two. Here we go. Walk them out. Hold high. Squeeze your butt twice. Heels, heels. Yeah, if you want, you can lift your toes off the ground here. I like to do that myself. Actively working hamstrings and glutes. Low back. Keep pressing the shoulder blades into the ground. Your gaze is straight up at the sky. Hold your bridge. Listen up. Just hold the bridge. Lift your right leg. Flex your foot. Sweep the leg. Heel drives down to the ground. Try not to let your hips drop, though. Add a little bit of power there, just on the drop. Should really feel your left leg now activate, or your opposing leg. Five, four, three, two. Drop the right leg. Put the foot down. Lift your left. Same thing. Sweep. Like you're going to chop something with your heel. There you go. Little dynamic power happening. Should be warming up now the opposing leg. Keep pressing in. Squeeze both cheeks nice and tight. I didn't realize I had a 25-minute warm-up ready for you guys. Last three, two, and one. You carefully come up. You can move your mat if you'd like. We should not need it for a little bit. You'll want one dumbbell, medium or a lighter. You've got a halo, alternating directions to start. Then we're going to pick up two moderate weights, and we've got some lunge work just to really get the glutes fired up. And if you're like, we're doing a halo, I need a 5-pound dumbbell. Quick, go grab one. Pick up the one dumbbell. You're going to bend the elbows, hold the weight close to you. Now, if you have this amazing pineapple on your head, this might be a little bit difficult. You're going to keep your arms close to you, draw a circle around your head, and then switch directions. We're going to be on my clock right now for 30 seconds. Yeah, that's it. We're just going to get the shoulder girdle ready because you do have a little overhead work today, specifically right after the warm-ups. You have a complex. I know it's not a surprise to most of us. Keep a little bend in the knees, core is tight, rib cage, draw it in. It's gonna wanna pop out when you lift your arms. Three, two, and one. You can hold no dumbbells here if you'd like. I'm gonna demo with no, option to hold two. Meet me right here in a lunge position. Keep your feet separate, back heel is lifted. Everybody down and up, static lunge. I got fake dumbbells in my hands for a second. I'm just giving you those options that you might need. You could drop down to one dumbbell if you needed. We're going to start to fire up the legs officially now. Are you ready? Hold. Just 10 seconds. Just 10 seconds. Two, one. You step left in, you step right back. You go down and up. That's it. Yeah. That's all she wrote right here. Three simple movements to really activate the body, the balance, the core, the heat, all the things we need. And then we're going to hit our complex, and that one's for sure going to take us on. Ready, set, bring it down and hold. Just 10. Feet have their own lane. Your back heel should be lifted, both toes forward. Three, two, step in. One dumbbell goes down. Second set, final set, and then we're going to complex. Elbows bent, halos. Let's go. Nice and controlled here. Just pay attention when you lift your elbows. What's happening? Are we extending out of the spine? Pull it in. It's a lot more core work than you think. You might notice your heart rate just came up, especially if you held weights for that lunge set. If you opted no weights, I'd like you to consider weights in the second round. 3, 2, 1. Grab dumbbells if you will. Just a few seconds. We'll put right foot forward. Get in position so I know you're ready. Lunge it. Let's go. We're pushing the weight out of the front heel. So you should feel activation happening in the entire thigh area, hamstring, quadricep, and then the instability of the split stance is giving us inner and outer thigh. Get ready, bring it down, 10 seconds, hold. This is where you build heat. This is an isolation, an isometric, which means we're targeting the legs. Great for the knee joint. 3, 2, step in, step back and lunge. Last 30 seconds right here, team. And then we're gonna hit complexes. You've got 4 movements in the complex. You'll be on a rep scheme. Pretty familiar if you're a regular in any of my classes whatsoever. Get ready to hold in 2 and 1, isometric. Hold it. Keep the core in tight, hold, stay low. Back knee is maybe hovering the ground. 2, 1, release. Warm up is done, check. Cool. Do you feel warmer? Yeah, okay, complex. Looks like this, it's a 6-4-6-4. Pretty sure I put 4 sets on here. We'll for sure do 3 sets, we might do 4. I'm gonna demo really quick. I'm gonna suggest a moderate weight load here. I know every week I'm like, go heavier every set. If you wanna go heavier, you have my permission. But on the other side, we have some heavier lift. So take it easy if you would like today. We start with 6 suitcase squats. Side hold, 6 of these. Then you're gonna transition the weights to the front, hinge, high pull, 4 reps. Then you're gonna rack them, 6 front squats. We finish, 4 push press. So 6 on the squats, both. And then 4 on the high pull, 4 on the push press. Start with a moderate if you're like, oh, I got a lot of wiggle room today. Ate my Wheaties, I slept good and I rested just like you said. Then you can go heavier. This will take you like maybe 40, 45 seconds to finish. Then we rest. Cool? All right, let's start with something a little bit moderate. Not light. Not light. Ready, set? 6 suitcase squats, let's go. Push your weight into your heels. Don't rush through these. These are for good quality reps always. Our goal is to hold the dumbbells the whole time. And then you put the weights in front, high pulls, hinge, elbows high. 1, 4 of them. 2, 3, 4, front rack, 6 squats. Open your feet a little wider. Elbows high if you can, especially if you're holding just moderate. If you picked up really heavy or you go heavier, you might need to adjust your hand placement. 4 push press, dip, drive, catch. Dip, drive, catch. We worked on this last week. When you're done, you're done. Spiked you up just a little? You're like, you let us go medium. How nice of you. Good, grab a sip of water if you need. We're all on a little recovery. Optional to go a little heavier. We for sure have 2 more sets. Then we're gonna get heavy. Last week when we did our complexes, we worked on that because Friday we went really heavy, small reps. Is that the right, I always say tiny. And you guys did amazing with that. Some of you went really heavy on Friday. All right, got about 10 seconds. Look at your weight selection, maybe your neighbors. Same exact thing. Yeah, if you want to go up and wait now because you practiced, this is the opportunity. Yeah. All right, are you guys ready? 6 suitcase squats, 4 high pull front squat, etc. 3, 2, let's go. 6 times. Sit it down. What are your armpits doing? Yeah. Crack a walnut in them. Oh, high pull nuts. Get the hips nice and low here. Reset. One rep at a time. Nice. Nice finish. I can tell when you guys go up just a smidge, you're like, ooh. At noon, they were doing the purse thing. That's my favorite. You recover. This is recovery. What do you do with your recovery? Nothing. Save your energy for the love of God. Sit down if you need water, breathe. If you want heavier, if you want it. I still didn't get my other set of weights out. Maybe that's my sign today. Same thing. Now we know the choreography. It's like your performance. Was that pretty good choreo? You guys look even better. Oh, shit. We'll talk after class. We'll talk after class. All right. Let's go for another round. I'm feeling four sets today. I don't know why. I know. You'll help me decide that. Let's do the third first before we get excited. Ready, set? Suitcase squats. Here we go. Six rounds. Nope, six reps. Let's not do six rounds, shall we? Four might be just enough. You're going to have an opportunity on the other side of these complexes to lift heavy. You always have the option. You don't have to wait for me. Reestablish your push press stance. Feet go back under the hips so you feel stable. Try to lock out and see that you're locked out. Don't falter like this. Lock it. Catch it. Yeah. Yeah, I think we need just a little more practice. Just a little. So sometimes you guys rest. These push presses can be a nuisance, right? Because you're tired and you just want to go fast and get it done. So here's what I see a lot of. And it's a mess and it's dangerous. So it's push, lock, catch, dip. Yeah, like you're a statue. If that means you got to drop in weight to do that, drop it. I'd rather have you do it well. And then when you get really good at it, then you go progressive. I told the noon class, it's about precision in a movement before you go to intensity. All right, we ready for a fourth round? We are so ready. We are primed and ready. Yeah, then we're going to get on the clock for these heavy supersets. I'm looking forward to some supersets. One more time, same thing. Five, four, three, two, one, go. Weight back into the heels. When you sit down, pull the core in tight. Little dip, pull. Nice. Weight stay close to the body. That's what it should sound like. You're so close. Dip, stick. Stick the landing. Did you hear what I just called y'all? Dipstick. I didn't mean that. Just came out. I wasn't calling you a dipstick. I was dip. Stick the landing. Cool. You guys are amazing. When you're done, you recover. Water, etc. I'm going to get you ready for what's ahead. Supersets. Every set, you have four rounds. The greatest news is they're all only 30 seconds. That being said, then I need something heavy from you. First superset is sumo deadlift, double dumbbell, heavy. Second movement is a single arm renegade row. So I'm going to demo all these things in case you need to modify. What's the difference, Ev? A deadlift leaves me hanging out here with a lot of power in my torso. A sumo deadlift. I like to double my weights here. If you like them here, you can. This just is because I'm super short. So my toes turn out. I've got a wide stance. Little bit of a bend in the knee. I'm hinging from my hip. Guess what's happening here? The medius and the hip are going. So you're going to be right here, 30 seconds. Cool. Second move right away. Option one, single arm renegade, heavy dumbbell, one. Option two, you can come up and do a single arm row here if you don't want to be in the wrist position. Deal? Deal. Yep, same arm for the whole 30. When we go to the second of four rounds, you'll go left. So it'll be right, left, right, left. But you're always getting a sumo dead. You're welcome. Well, let's not get too excited over here. Yep, I love you're all doing, test it out if you need, test a rep. Test a rep, because if you can't do the sumo, you can just do an RDL or a suitcase deadlift. You can choose. Test this out. How does that feel? Yeah, you got a bend in the knees, yep. A little bit of the hinge here, a lot of back load. Big hamstring, big medial glute. Dana, you're gonna love these. All right. 30 seconds on my clock, we start with sumo deads. In position, you're over your weights, toes turned out, ready, set. Let's go, 30 seconds is on, move. And if you're like, I hate these, me too. Actually, I love these. There's something to be said about being short on a deadlift. Yeah, you tall folks, I'm really sorry for you. Us short people have an easier time with deadlifts. It's a shorter range to pull. I can pull 150 pounds faster than you can. Upper back, what are your armpits doing? Right, that's all about armpits today. 3, 2, 1. Little transition time, one arm is coming in. Keep your heart rate high when you're ready. Palm flat, toes wide. Here we go. Single arm. Renegade row. You can drop to the knees for this. I feel like it shorts my range of motion a little bit personally, but if that works for you, please take it on. Halfway. We'll take a brief recovery before we do set two. That's four sets of these. Yeah. 3, 2, 1. All right, now you know the work. You're like, didn't work for me. I don't like it. Modify it. And you don't have heavy enough weight? Hustle up and get some. How are we doing, virtual friends? They're all like, we're just watching you. You're recording this. We can do it later. Recovery's gone. Yay! Stand over those weights like they're yours, like you own them. 3, 2, let's go. Set two. They're going to go quick because they're only 30 seconds. And I'm giving you way more recovery than we need. Upper back tight. Hard to round in this one, right? Because you feel like you're going to fall over. How's your grip feeling, heavyweight holders? Yeah, it's alive. 5 seconds. This time the other arm rows. 2, 1. Left arm's gonna row. It's right, left in the series. In position, when you're ready, set, go. Feel your 3-point stance kind of wide. Your palm is flat under the shoulder. Your toes are wide so your obliques can push into that anti-rotation. Holy buckets. If you picked up something heavy, this feels challenging. Two, one. How's it going? Two sets down, two to go. Repeat, right and left. Then we'll move to a different superset. And then we have an AMRAP, and then we have 60-second rounds to punch out. We got lots of work to do today. We're just amping you up. You got 10 seconds. Let's not mess around. In position, round three. Right arm's gonna roll. Three, two, let's go. Sumos. Dead, or if you're modifying, modify this, you guys. You have my permission. This should be slow and controlled at best. Halfway. How's the lower body feeling? Awake and alive. Three, two, one. When you come down here, team, wide stance, strong positioning. You could hold this for a minute. We're not holding it though. Ready, set, right arm rows, go. One at a time, bring it back down. Breathe, pull, exhale. Keep the gaze by the hands so we avoid tucking the chin. Five, three, two, one. One more time. Yeah, feeling a little warmer now. It's our last set of sumos and rowing, and then we're gonna get into some glute work and some chest work. Heavy load, same exact kind of lineup. 5 seconds, team. In position, last set. Three, two, let's roll out, go. You find your range of motion, the movement that actually makes sense for your body today. I guarantee there are days most of us, if not all of us, have a movement we love, we just can't do. That's okay. Be in the struggle with each other. 5 seconds. Two, one. Left arm's gonna row. Then we get set up for a different round, different superset. Three, two, let's go. You exhale as you draw the elbow high. Nice. I love all the mods even. You guys look really strong this afternoon. Keep it up, keep it up. 10 seconds to go. Just a couple more reps if you can. Three, two, time. Yay. All right, you recover, grab water. Next superset, 4 rounds. Round one, you're in a right leg lunge. Ideal world for Heather's notes, double dumbbell, static. 30 seconds moving right into heavy load. 30 seconds, either a standard chest press or close grip. You could mix and match that if you wanted. One, two, three, four. You could do one, you could do two, etc. Clear? So we go right lunge, chest press, left lunge, you're gonna get 4 sets of chest press. There's no push-ups in there, so you should be excited. Yeah. Now listen, look at that. Running out of time. Don't wait to pick up heavy later and work hard later. Now, you got to do it now, because everything else is going to be moderate load. So it's our last shot to go super heavy if we want to. Static lunge, I like, because I can focus on my core, my balance, and isometrically just pumping it out. It's only 30 seconds. Get ready. Pick up one, two, or no dumbbells. You choose. Ready, set. Three, two, go. Back heel is lifted. Make your stance a non-negotiable. Feet are hip to shoulder distance. You should easily see your other foot. In the mirror, your heel is lifted. Yeah. Little lean forward in the torso. and then push yourself back, actively working the glutes, quads, and hamstrings. Yeah. Remember the pursed lips I told you about? This is why they were doing them. 2, 1. Maybe on the mat for chest press, your choice. I'll give you 6 seconds to set up. Safely pick them up. Clock starts in 2 and 1. Here we go. Elbows can drastically touch the floor, but don't rest them too long. Tap them, press them. I'd like you to have really heavy for all 4 supersets. You should notice that in your cardiovascular health right here. Yeah, Jude. The lunges have our heart rate up. Chest press keeps it up. 6 seconds. Can you get 2 more presses? 4, 3, 2. Take a little break. We're clear. The other leg's got to go. Left side. Just think, when you guys come to cycle at 5:30, we're just going to flush out the legs. You heard me. I'm starting early with my recruitment. Left foot in front, right foot back. Before you go anywhere, take a look at your stance. I see a lot of this and a lot of this. This is not a warrior position. Lunge, pick them up. 3, 2, let's go. Same exact weight now. You can't have one side that's imbalanced. You might not get a lot of reps because it's heavy weight and it's 30 seconds. I don't care. Our goal right now is heavy load, whatever that might mean. 10 seconds. Press through the front heel. 3, 2, 1. Six seconds. In position we go. 3, 2, let's move. Chest press, please. Elbows are just below the shoulder points. Unless you're gonna close grip, then they're grazing the rib cage or the side of the body. Keep the core tight, shoulder blades pressing into the ground. Ha. Punch the knuckles to the ceiling. How they feeling? Pretty amazing, I hope. 3, 2, and 1. 2 sets done. Done, that works. 2 to go. Back to the right leg. Holy buckets. Just set yourself up for a right leg lunge, please. I'm running low on time, so I'm gonna push you a little bit hard here. Absolutely. Yes, ma'am. Ready, set, 3, 2, lunge, go. I'll wait for everybody to pick them up. Clock starts right now. 30 seconds is on. Right side, left side. That's all we've got left. Ten more seconds, please. Uh-oh. 3, 2, 1. Oh! Five seconds. 3, 2, go.
Make noise.
We inhale, we exhale, press. Yeah. Yep. Halfway. They should feel V heavy right now, team. Good. Otherwise, I'm by myself and that's boring. 4, 3, 2, 1. One more. Left leg, chest press, we move on. Oh, I'm gonna have to cut one thing out and I'm very sad about that. Maybe, maybe. Okay, let's get moving then. Everybody keep moving so I can get these notes done. Ready, set, go, left leg. Hold up, wait a minute. This feels great. Do you feel stronger yet? Yeah, halfway. It's only 30 seconds, y'all. We do 40, 45 a lot in here. You got it. Two, one. Last set of chest press here. You're going in 7 seconds. Set it up. Three, two, go. Yeah. Smooth. Strong. That's all we're doing. We're just pressing for 30 seconds. It's not 40. It's not 60. Up. 6 seconds left. Get two more, four, three, two, one. Cool, cool. Keep your mats out. I'm gonna try to cram in two more things. I'm gonna cut off at the end what I need to cut off, but you got a 3 minute AMRAP, very small reps. I'd go moderate weight here. Moderate-ish, moderate to heavy. Your rep scheme is my best friend's favorite, 2-2-4. Two strict press, two thrusters, drop them, four push-ups. Option, 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 option. Bear plank push-ups, times four. I go with a higher elevated dumbbell, like put hands here if you needed. Two strict press, two thruster, four push-up, 3 minutes. Round and round and round. Cool. It's only 3 minutes of work, friends. And then you've got some practice and some 60s. We're going to have to skip the practice. That's okay. We'll get through it together. We might have to do some of it tonight and do more of it next week. Is that okay? Two strict press, two thruster, four push-up. You guys ready for this? Yes. Take a breath. 3 minutes on my clock in three, two, go. Two, as strict as you can get them. Two thrusters. Four push-ups. Any variation will do. For convenience sake, I like the bear plank. But I'm not going to lie, I don't like how they feel. You come up. Oh my gosh. Yep, that's it. All I got is 20 seconds. That does not be, I see. It's a lot of shoulders in that bear plank push-up. Sorry, not sorry. It's going to be a long 3 minutes. Did I tell you guys that? The reason my best friend hates the 2-2-4 is because it's a long death of 3 minutes when you have really tiny reps. Or very few movements. One minute in. Hey, if you need to adjust your weight, to do it quickly. I respect that. This is why I don't think we can get to that last. You guys will hate me. This is kind of how Friday sounded. Yes. You're halfway. 30, or 90 seconds in. 90 to go. I know it feels some type of way, but you're so close to the finish. Keep in motion now. Keep in motion, best you can. Ah. 1 minute left. How's your upper body? Feels like the ceiling's on your back right now. Yeah, same. Just keep moving. Do what you can do. You're not like, I wish I had an award for us after. Our award is a 5:30 cycle class. Yeah, 30 seconds. Get another round in. Go. Yeah. 20. Let's go, Patrick. Come on. 15. 10. Get them back up if you can. 5, 4, 3, 2. Time. Shoot. All right, can I get your attention? Okay. What I have for us is 4 minutes of work. What we don't have is 4 minutes. And I wanted to practice. So we're just going to test one of these minutes and see how we do. If after that minute we do really well, we'll go to the second. Minute 3 and 4 will repeat. So let's try them today. And then I'm going to bring them back next week and we're going to do all the rounds that I promised. Deal? Deal. Moderate set of dumbbells, please. You will be on a clock for a full minute, broken down in 20-second sets. 2 movements. I'm going to need the demo. Really brief. No, you're good. I just want to make sure I didn't take yours. Here's what it's going to look like. You've got 20 seconds. You're going to do one row, one squat clean. One row, one squat clean. When I say change, you're going to squat clean. 20 seconds. When I say change, you're going to row the last 20. So we go from hardest to easiest. 20, 20, 20. That's it. That's all I got. Try it with me. One row, one clean. When I say change, just clean. When I say change, just row. Grab a moderate set, maybe a light set if you're unfamiliar with a squat clean. Cool? On a clock for this long, I wouldn't go super heavy. All right, one row, one squat clean in 3, 2, let's go. Bent over row once, clean it, catch, sit. Do it again. Row, clean and catch. Here's the situation. Little heart rate's coming up here. Just squat clean right now. Speed, struggle, struggle. It's a struggle, all right. Shrug, get under the dumbbell. Your heart rate coming up? If it isn't, you're not doing it right. Row. What are you doing? Get down there. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. 3, 2, rest. Do you like it? Can we try the other one? Can we try the other one? Okay. Second one. One fly, one squat jump. 20 seconds. Fly. Squat jump. Do you have to jump? Just squat and heel raised. Okay? When I say change, you drop into a squat jump. When I say change, you fly, and then we're done. Then we're done. 1 more minute. Yeah. Just get yourselves ready. It's enough recovery. One fly, one squat jump. Get ready. 3, 2, go. Stand up. Get your jump in there. Fly. One jump. Yep. Squat jump. Or squat heel raise. You can let the weights go too if you need. 10 more seconds. 10 more seconds, less than. Keep going, keep going. 3, 2, fly, fly, just fly. I know it's hard to do when your heart rate's high. I know, you're almost there. 12 seconds. End of class is coming. 10. Bend your knees a little. Power up. 3, 2, time. I told the noon class because they don't drop their dumbbells like that. I'm so unfamiliar with it. Oh, team. We get crammed a lot in. Are you ready to cool down? Same. Meet me when you're ready and not a moment before. We'll go down into child's pose. Don't rush. I'm going to spend about 3 or 4 minutes, just quick stretches. Just enough to get you landed. And then you can stretch on your own account after cycle. Is that 3 or 4? I got 3 more in my back pocket for you. And that's how a Monday should be done. We just conquered it all. You can choose extended child's pose or traditional. One has knees open, forehead down, reach your arms away from you. Traditional, knees are together. Forehead still down, but my hands are going to come to my heels on the floor. The extended allows your low back to really rest and recover. The traditional is going to give your spine a little bit more length, extension, excuse me, flexion and space between the vertebrae. Forehead is down when you're there. No rush. Take a breath. I am so honored and humbled that you guys make time to come in here each week. It's a really big deal to me. So I like to remember to say thank you. Although I don't fully understand the details of what it takes for each of you to get here, I have some understanding of our busy lives that we all lead and the challenges that you are up against every day to find movement and well-being for yourself. So the fact that you carved out the 45-ish minutes today is a big props from me to you. Thank you very much for being a part of my day. You can stay in child's pose. This studio is open until the 6 o'clock class. So you got like another half hour. If you'd like to come out with me and stretch just for a couple of minutes, find tabletop position, curl your toes. Palms are flat under the shoulders. We're going to start with cat and cow first. So exhale, round your spine, tuck your chin. As you inhale, you lift your gaze, your chin, drop your belly, lift your tailbone. Go between these two movements with an exhale rounding and an inhale extending. We're going to hold cat when I give you the cue and shift a little bit, gliding into the wrists and ankles and feet. When you're ready, hold the cat position. You don't have to worry about your breath, just breathe naturally and then shift into the wrists and hands. Shift back into the toes, hips toward the heels, continually lifting your upper back, mid back toward the ceiling. Take downward facing dog by lifting your knees, your hips to the sky, pedaling your feet right and left, right and left. Press your chest toward your thighs. Bring your right foot forward, runner's lunge, drop your back knee. You start right here, taking a little bit of press into your runner's lunge, and then see if you can extend and find a little hamstring stretch and go between front and back, creating a little hip mobility, Half pigeon would be a great place to land. Maybe in the hamstring stretch, see if you can rock your foot right to left. Really accentuating the hamstring stretch. Stay as long as you'd like in either the hip or the hamstring. In about 10 seconds, we'll switch legs. Let's find down dog one more time. Stretch, 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 and then take your left foot forward. Drop your back knee. Start with the rock forward and start to mobilize again. Unloaded, no more weight, just you and your body. Trying to find a little mobility after class, after your workouts. Make sure you are stretching 20 to 30 minutes at some point. Same day ideal. Right after is convenient, and I understand that doesn't work for everybody, but at some point on the same day. Take a big inhale and exhale here. We're gonna find ragdoll when you're ready, not a rush. Feet are gonna go under the hips, hip distance, bend the knees, head hangs heavy. Shake your head yes and no. Certainly find some time for hip stretching, half pigeons, figure fours, upper body pec stretch, and then back stretch, just spinal rotation, a couple minutes each side. With your knees bent, put your hands on your thighs. Stay right here. Tuck everything in your upper body into a ball and slowly come up. Mid-back, shoulders, chin is the very last. Once you're up, inhale, roll, shoulders up, back, and down. You guys can stretch a little more on your own after cycle. I did what I did. Exhale all your air out. We're going to take our two final breaths together. Inhale, arms up. Open your mouth and exhale. One more time. Let me hear it, Monday. Inhale. Louder. Exhale. Oh, that was beautiful. Nice job, everybody. Make sure you stretch, hydrate, clean off your equipment, and I'll see you guys next door. This class starts at 5:30. Have a great evening, and I will 5:30 to 6-ish. 5:30 to 6-ish. You can leave when you need to leave. If you want to come 5:30 to 5:35, you have my permission. I'll see you guys later. Take care. Thank you.